gonna be underdogs. Today we prove the American Navy isn't a joke. You'll remember this moment for the rest of your life.
Basically, I actually had a small part in Independence Day Resurgence,
wow.
But a scene got cut, so it doesn't really count.
Semi counts. Second time around, you're working with, you know, the director.
How do you deal with working the director? Great. I mean, Roland is such a professional. Like, he knows exactly what he wants and doesn't waste any time.
Mm-hmm.
And what was really great is that I knew the action was going to be incredible.
Yeah.
But then what I didn't expect and what I think he did really well was telling the story authentically. Like, he didn't have to add anything, you know? Like, the stuff that people had to go back through back then was crazy, and he captured that so well without the use of like CGI. Didn't need any of that.
Well, as far as I understand, this movie is very, very realistic. It's based on a true story.
Absolutely.
So that's it. If you were the person who's actually fighting the war, what kind of feeling do you have?
Oh, I think it's word for word, I would be nervous. I would be extremely nervous because you, especially how they were trained, they had no time, right? It was reaction. So they were in training, but they were thrown right away into the war. So you really have to rely on your training, which you just had, and then you got to rely on yourself saying you think you can do it and truly believe that you can, right?
This one was much more specific and true to the actual story. You know, a lot of times people will take creative license to tell the story that they want to tell. Wes Took, the writer of this, was very specific and deliberate in telling the truest tale he possibly could. And I think he did a great job. I'd be reading through the script and would think, well, that can't possibly have happened. But then sure enough, you do the research and you find out, wow, that actually did, and it happened in that way. So it's just a very specific retelling of this tale, and one that's very authentic to the actual skirmish.
Well, I tell you, once I read the script written by Wes Took, amazing writer, dealing with a topic that was so big and it was such a big scale, he did an incredible job. It's a multi-layered script. There's a wonderful romance. You know, so I think there's something for everyone. I think the women coming to see the film are going to appreciate, you know, the cost of like sending some your loved one off to war. And I think he touched on that brilliantly. And I think that, you know, he really took an immense subject and condensed it in a beautiful flowing fashion so that you not only understand the history, but you can really like get involved and really, you know, let your heart become involved in it.
So what impact do you hope it not only on audiences but on filmmakers?
I think it's proof that you can do it, and secondly, I think we're all very proud of the film because everybody gave up a little, and everybody was super pumped to do it all together. And then you put like some monuments to some people which otherwise probably would be forgotten, which is also a cool thing. You know, I think nobody really knew about Dick Best. And it's a good thing that now people know about him. He was an incredible, you know, hero. And that's like kind of, and I think it's also, you know, I noticed a little bit because I did The Patriot, how often The Patriot will go be shown in schools. So you have that kind of you be around for a long time.
Mark has mentioned that you put everything into such details. What's the preparation time for you for this movie?
Well, in a weird way, I prepared this movie for 20 years because I wanted to make it since 20 years. But we had a long, maybe unusually long preparation time.